Hey there, students. Today, our learning target is I can simplify polynomial expressions by finding the product of two or more monomials. And remember, a monomial is a polynomial with only one term. And always remember, stay strong, you got this. So for our warm-up, we're going to continue with our theme of past and present. For question number one, it says, what is the solution set for -3x plus 10 is greater than 6x plus 64? And you wanna be able to pick one of these answer choices accurately. For this problem, you can certainly use nSolve. You just have to remember that when using nSolve, that this has to be an equal sign. So I'll let you go ahead and solve that one using nSolve. If you don't remember how, please ask for help. That's what I'm here for. For question number two, it's asking you to find the perimeter of the rectangle shown below. So here we have a rectangle, and I want you to find the perimeter. And this is what we've been talking about in class for the past, for last week, how to simplify a polynomial expression. But this one you'll have to set up. So remember, to find the perimeter, you're simply adding all the sides. So for the number two, you are going to recall that in a rectangle, this side and this side are both the same. So let me try a different color here. This side and this side are both the same. So I can set this up as 3x plus 1, then plus another 3x plus 1, since those two sides are the same. And then this side and this side are the same. So we can also set that up as plus 2x minus 1, or 2 minus x. And then I'm going to have another 2 minus x. And for this, we are just going to utilize combining like terms to find the perimeter. So by now, you should be able to find the perimeter here. I know that 3x is like 3x, which is like the minus 1x, and like the minus 1x. So if we look at the 3, the negative 1, and the negative 1, well, 3 plus 3 is 6. If I take 1 away, that's going to be 5. If I take 1 more away, that's going to be 4. So this would be 4x. Now if I look at the numbers without the variable, those are also like terms. I have 1 plus another 1 is 2. Plus 2 is 4, plus 2 is 6. So that is going to be 4x plus 6 is my perimeter. And so for our lesson today, let's get into some key vocabulary. This is a monomial because it's only one term. And within this monomial, we can identify three different vocabulary terms. Most of you, if not all, is familiar with what an exponent is. So this exponent of 3, we can say that this is 2m cubed, and this 3 just tells me how many times I'm taking this m and multiplying it by itself. Some of us for the past week were trying to cube this number 2, which this 3 is only with the m. Another vocabulary term we should be familiar with is what a coefficient is, and a coefficient is simply a number that's multiplied by a variable term. So here my coefficient is 2. And a new vocabulary word is going to be base. And we consider a base is any number or variable raised to a power. So in this case, m is my base because it's raised to the third power. So keep in mind these three vocabulary terms as we talk about simplifying these expressions when we find the product of monomials. So for our first example, I want you to write this down in your journal. Hopefully you also are writing down the key vocabulary as well. But I want you to write this example down in your journal, and we want to write an equivalent expression, or we want write an expression equivalent to this. So in more or less, we need to simplify this expression. And if we can kind of read it to ourselves, it's negative x cubed times 4x squared. And so we know that there is a coefficient of 4 in front of the x squared, but even though we don't see the coefficient in front of x cubed, I can write a 1 in there, and now this coefficient is negative 1. And the way in which that we are going to simplify this, since we are multiplying, so this little dot here tells me that I'm going to multiply. Last week, all we did was find the sum and the difference, or we added and subtracted. So this is going to be different than adding and subtracting. When we multiply monomials, we are going to, well, first, we're going to expand this out. So I know that this cubed here, this power of 3, this is telling me to take this x and multiply it by itself 3 times. So I'm going to go ahead and expand that out. So I have negative 1 times x times x times x. This would be the expanded form of this here. And then I'm multiplying this by 4, and then x squared is x times x. So right now, all I've done is just expand this expression here out. And then I can simplify it. So my coefficients, which is the negative 1 and the 4, those I can multiply together. So negative 1 times 4, that's just negative 4. However, these x's here, when I multiply those together, I'm going to combine them into a single x, but then I'm going to represent that multiplication using an exponent or a power. So if x cubed was x times x times x, and x squared was x times x, I have a total of 5 x's. I have an x here, an x here, an x here, another x, another x. So I have a total of 5 x's. That means I can rewrite this as x to the 5th power. And this would be my answer, because this expression here is equivalent to this expression that we started with. So let's try another one. So here we have 7r times negative r squared times 2r to the 4th power. So immediately we can tell that the negative r squared needs the coefficient of a 1, so that's negative 1. And then I'm going to go ahead and expand each of these out like we did before. This r, it does have an exponent, but we just don't see it, and so it has an exponent of 1. That means when I rewrite this, it's just going to be the same. There's nothing really to expand out there. Times negative 1, and I have r squared, so that's r times r, times 2, and we have r to the 4th power, so that's just r times r times r times r. Now that we have each monomial expanded, I can go ahead and find the product of all three. So we start with our coefficients, 7 times negative 1 times 2. Well, if you're not sure what that is, use your calculator. 7 times negative 1 is negative 7. And then that number times 2 is negative 14. So negative 14. And then we simply take our r's. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And when I multiply those, that's r to the 7th power, because that's the total number of r's we're multiplying by themselves. And so this would be my answer here. So this 14, negative 14 r to the 7th power, is equivalent to this expression we started with. And I want you to try these three in your journal. So go ahead and write them down, and I want you to multiply them out in the similar way that we just did. This is your first, you try it on your own. And if you need help, I'll be walking around helping you. So now let's see how you did. If we take the product of 2s to the 4th times negative 3x squared, you see I've expanded it here. 2 times negative 3 was negative 6, and there were 6 total s's, so it was s to the 6th power. For the second problem you were expected to do, it was 3x to the 1st power times 5x squared. So again, I expanded that out, and I got 3x times 5xx. And when we multiply that together, 3 times 5 is 15, and there were 3 x's total, so x cubed. And the last problem you were expected to do, 4w squared times 1w cubed times negative 1w to the 1st power. Here I expanded that out again, so 4 and then the 2 w's, times 1 and then the 3 W's, and then times negative 1 in the single W. So 4 times 1 is 4, times negative 1 is negative 4, and there were 6 W's total that we were multiplying by itself. So W, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's the answers you should have received. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to ask. That's what I'm in the classroom walking around for. So now let's look at a third example. We want to now multiply monomials when there's more than one variable. So in this case, we have 2x squared y times negative 4xy cubed. And the process is more or less still the same. I want to expand out each monomial before I combine them as a single monomial. So 2 times x and then times y, because that's y to the first power. And this has been multiplied by negative 4 times x and then times y times y times y. So this here is just the expanded form of what we started with. So this exponent of 2 tells me to write two x's. There's only one y, so I wrote only one y. There's only a single x in this term, and there's y cubed, so that means y times y times y. Now, when we multiply it, I can only multiply like bases together. And so in this case, we're still gonna start with our coefficients. So 2 times negative 4, which is negative 8. So that process is not any different. But the second process we are looking at, well, I have an x times another x, and those are the only ones I can actually combine into a single x with raised to a power. So since there's three of them, that's x cubed. And then I'm going to look at my y's now. I have a single y in the first term, and I have three y's in the second term. And so when I multiply those together, I have y to the fourth power, because there's four y's I'm multiplying by themselves. And this happens to be my result. When I take this monomial times this monomial, this is the result that I get. Negative 8 x cubed y to the fourth power. All right, let's look at let's see if you can try it on your own. If not, feel free to ask for help. This is no different than the first couple that we did together and the ones that you tried on your own. There has the additional variable, which you'll just have to focus on. And we'll look at, I'll go over it with you after you finish. So let's see how you did. We have 3m to the first power n cubed times negative 2 m to the second power into the first power. So if I expand it out, we have 3 times m times n times n times n. So that's this expanded out, times negative 2 times m times m times n. And then when I combine it, I have 3 times negative 2, which is negative 6. And I have 1, 2, 3 m's I'm multiplying by themselves, so that's m cubed. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4 n's that I'm multiplying by itself, so that's n to the fourth power. And then in the second problem you were supposed to do on your own, I have negative 1 s squared t times negative 3 s squared t cubed. And so this is the expanded form, negative 1 s times s times t times negative 3 s times s times t times t times t. And so when I get all that back together, a negative 1 times a negative 3 is positive 3, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4 s's, so s to the fourth power, and 1, 2, 3, 4 t's, so t to the fourth power. And so for our fourth example, let's look at, again, writing an equivalent expression, but this one does look a bit different than the other ones. Here we have our monomial, x squared, and it's raised to the fourth power. And I'm still gonna go along with the process of expanding it out. This x squared tells me to multiply this x by itself two times, but this fourth power on the outside tells me to take this entire expression and multiply it by itself four times. So when I expand this out, this is going to be x squared times x squared times x squared times x squared. And then if I further expand out the x's, that'll be x times x, and then x times x, and then x times x, and then another x times x. So when I reduce this down to a single x raised to a power to represent all the x's we're multiplying by themselves, how many x's do we have total? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is equal to x to the 8th power. So let's look at a second example. Now we have 4m squared raised to the 3rd power. And again, if I expand this out, this power of 3 is just going to tell me to multiply 4m squared by itself 3 times. So I'm going to do that, 4m squared. Well, and then within the parentheses, I can expand out the m's. And now we can simplify our expression. I have 4 times 4 times 4. So if you're not sure what that is, multiply that in your calculator. 4 times 4 is 16, times another 4 is 64. And then how many m's do we have total? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this will represent m to the 6th power. And this is my simplified expression. And I want you to go ahead and try these three in your journal as well. This is your final, you try it, just to see how well you're grasping the concept. And again, if you're not getting it, feel free to ask me for help. And then we're gonna go over these problems as well in the video. So the first one, the power of 2 tells me to multiply this expression by itself twice. So I wrote 5r squared times 5r squared. And then within the parenthesis, I expanded it out. So 5RR, 5RR. And then when we want to put this back together, 5 times 5 is 25. And there were 4 R's, 1, 2, 3, 4, that I was multiplying by itself. So I have R to the 4th power. For the second example, or for the second problem in your you try it, we have 2X cubed raised to the 4th power. So this power of 4 is telling me to multiply this expression inside the parentheses by itself 4 times. So that's what I have here, 2x cubed times 2x cubed times 2x cubed times 2x cubed. And then I went ahead and expanded that out 4 times. So 2 and then 3x's, 2 and then 3x's, 2 and then 3x's, and so on. And when I get this back together, 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16. If you don't know that, put that in your calculator. And then we're just simply counting the x's, because those are the like bases. So x plus x plus x, we do that, and we get x to the 12th power. For the last one, I was just a little too lazy to write that out, so this is the answer you should have gotten. If you're not sure how we get that answer, again, feel free to ask me, and then I will help you through it. For your practice today, I'm gonna have you go to Khan Academy now that you're done with the video, and then we will practice this again tomorrow with some application type problems.